Welcome to the heartland of the Philippines, Masbate City. Banking on its strategic position as the capital of the province of Masbate and being blessed with one of the finest harbors in the country, Masbate City took its position as one of the most fast emerging center for trade and commerce. The account that Masbate was coined after the words masa and bate remains anecdotal, rich with a mixture of facts and folklore. Masbate was first explored by Captain Luis de Guzman in 1569. The town of Masbate was first established as the capital or provincial capital shortly before the restoration of the Philippine independence in 1946. In August 16, 2000, Republic Act 8807 was signed converting the municipality of Masbate into a component city. On September 30, 2000, the Commission on Elections Regional Office officially proclaimed Masbate as a component city and consequently as the first and only city in the province of Masbate. Masbate City is a blessed land with its innumerable bounty and little blight. It is situated strategically in the center of the Philippine archipelago. The city is also more or less situated at the center of the province of Masbate. The city serves as the dividing line between Luzon and the rest of the islands in the country. From Manila, the city is barely 212.5 aerial miles. By plane, it takes more or less 1 hour to travel, and by boat, about 16 to 18 hours. To the neighboring islands, Masbate City is 1 hour and 45 minutes from the nearest point in Bicol mainland. Away from the nearest point in Burias, 45 minutes away from the nearest municipality of Tikau Island, 8 hours from the nearest point in the island of Cebu, and 5 hours from the nearest point in Panay Island. Masbate City is very much characterized by its untapped but rich cultural heritage. Its language, Masbate is a blend of at least 5 dialects such as Bicol, Waray, Hiligaynon, Tagalog and Cebuano. Housed in Masbate City are beautiful heritage houses. Today, Masbate City takes its pride as the origin of the world-renowned Philippine folk dance known as the Lapay Bantigi Dance. This dance has existed and has become an important aspect of the local culture of the people of Barangay Bantigi. It is through the totally artistic and sanguine spirit of Ramon A. Obusan that the Lapay dance has now become so popular all over the world as one of the most beautiful and original folk dances. Today, the Lapay Dance Festival is one of the most well-participated festivals in the province, celebrated annually during the city anniversary. Nowhere in the entire country can you find the first and only coastal resource management interpretive center than in the city of Masbate. With a CRMIC, Masbate City took its position as a CRM showcase tour staging area. This center was designed to showcase and promote efforts to protect and manage Masbate's rich coastal environment and heritage, and serve as the hub of all CRM-related information, education, communication, training, and outreach activities of the city. The Coastal Resource Management Project of the city began in 2000. Masbate City has very strong and comprehensive program in the protection of its abundant coastal resources and marine habitat. Through this, the city was able to establish two well-protected marine sanctuaries, such as the Buntod Reef and the Bititong Marine Sanctuaries. The organization of the deputized fish wardens of the Bantay Dagat as official vanguards of the sea was very instrumental in the total eradication of dynamite fishing in the territorial waters of the city.
We in the city government are very committed in the promotion of our ecotourism potentials. We believe that protection and promotion of our environmental potentials are the best way to sustain the growth and development of our tourism industry. As the city knew, tourism is one of our agenda for development. Its benefits and impacts will surely improve the quality of life of our people. Our ecotourism program offers best hope for Masbate's future. Dayon po kamo sa Masbate City, action pa dayon.